Welcome back to Let's Play DDO Permadeath. So here I am in the Restless Isles, having done hips previously. And my plan this session is to get all the way across to Slavers and get that done. We will see if that plan works out. Okay, usual tactic here. I'm going to charge through and drop some damage on the far side. Okay, so this explorer area is confusing as hell, but I really enjoy it. It's very different from most of the other explorer areas. Alright, since I'm going this way, let's just unlock this door. Maybe that's not such a good plan. Okay, we'll do it the other way then. I suppose this is also a good time to note that falling off the edge here, falling off of these islands, is instant death, which is kind of a problem for permadeath. So, I think the official position in the guild is that accidental death, falling off the edge, doesn't count as a character death if it's just a fat finger, but getting knocked off by enemies or falling off during a fight does count as a death. I said I've never fallen off yet, so hopefully that doesn't hopefully we don't get to make that decision. Like a lot of the permadeath guilds, Extreme Explorers operates on an honor system for people deleting or removing their characters when they die. And Extreme Explorers is one of the more relaxed guilds. Lag-induced deaths don't count, for instance. Although, fortunately, I've never really had one where it was necessary to think about that. This is the other nice thing with this area. There's a really clear kind of structure to it. The explorer area clearly has a whole story going on with the miners being forced to, sorry, the wildmen being forced to mine for the ogres. You don't really see that in many of the explorer areas. They're just kind of monsters wandering around. I'm really enjoying this this great axe. Having nullification on my main melee weapon is working really nicely for this guy. In particular with Necrotic Ray, giving me some good range damage that I can use even while I'm meleeing. Right, these bridges are really dangerous, as I've already noted. Falling off is death. So I'm going to stay in the middle as much as possible. Fortunately, although some of the enemies out here do knock you around a bit, they don't push you around, unlike enemies in some areas. If there were giants out here, that would just be cruel and unusual, I think. I use magic missile a lot, you'll notice, for pulling aggro. It was a recommendation I saw on the DDO forums, I think from maybe the Sorcerer's Handbook. Magic Missile is a very cheap spell. It goes around corners, so it's a good way of just selecting an enemy and them getting their attention. This area is very difficult to navigate around, but fortunately I know it pretty well. I almost always solo Slavers on every character. Slavers is a real nice quest. Shame, Named Scorpion isn't here. I don't suppose I will be coming this way again, so if he's not here now, I won't be getting him. I'm kind of going through spell points here. Enemies are kind of spread out. Although I've just killed 50 enemies since coming in, so I guess I am getting free stuff. Alright, what's a mystic when it's at home? Looks like a cleric. Cleric is bad news, since I'm in vampire form. I think I'll stick with it, though. I did have a look before starting this session whether it was possible to get to the fifth tier Pale Master enhancements now. Specifically trying to get the improved shrouding. Wow, Nock is struggling in here. Hardly worth the spell points for one chest. Looks like he tried to use a negative spell on me rather than a light spell. Bad move. Alright, let's save some spell points by sticking to melee damage for a bit. Whoa, whoa, whoa. He had a go at pushing me off there. The mage tried to dodge out, but I got him with my axe. That one took less damage. The way he went, my Slayer count didn't go up, so he must still be around. So dangerous on these edges here. I see a mystic in the back. He's awkwardly placed over there. Let's get behind a rock out of his sight. Always have to be careful jumping around on these islands. I actually wouldn't want the jump spell on running around out here, for too much risk of doing a wild jump and going over the edge. I don't think the cleric heard me. Fortunately, they don't get many vampires out here. Because those guys do not know how to fight them. Okay. I'd like to get all of the explorers over this side while I'm here. Although I could do with more spell points, really. So which is this one going to? Oh. This is probably the worst fight out here. Although it's much easier on this type of character since you can drop an AoE. Alright, that's trapped with a trap that shoots you off to instant death, so let's not go up there. At least I think that's the one that is trapped that way. Alright, one of six explorers done. Yeah, that fight was pretty easy, and I got lucky they didn't debuff me at all there. Or I don't see any important buffs gone. Alright, here's the quest entrance. So do I have the key to this door yet? Good. Yeah, this isn't gonna go well. And there's a mystic in the back, damn it. Damn it. Yeah, that was how not to target spells. Okay. I know what I'm doing. Damn it, these guys resist fire damage. They don't seem to use any light damage though, those clerical enemies. So that's good news. Alright, I've got the explorer, so I don't really need to hang around here. Alright, that's all the way through. There is that locked room back there. Is that worth dicing with? It's a big fight, as I recall. My skeleton has plenty of hit points, though. Don't even know if I can open it. Let's find out. Good luck, skeleton. That's not gonna help him. This would be a really dumb place to die. Alright, we're in control now. Ah, that was an explorer. Okay, it was worth doing then. I think that chest is just a key. Anyway, I'm not gonna chance it. Yes, maybe I should have drunk a mnemonic pot before trying that one. That is one of the hardest fights out here. Right, I don't want my skeleton for the quest. I guess I don't have any kind of diplomacy type item at the moment. I guess it doesn't matter. Cool. All right. My plan is to attempt the quest on hard, and I don't know if that's going to be possible or not, but I'm going to give it a try. I guess I'd have a lot less cheap damage since I can't really take my skeleton in with me. And I can't really use my healing aura for a lot of the fights because it harms the slaves. So, we will see how this goes. This is not a quest that I normally do on hard. In fact, this will certainly be my first time soloing it on hard. But I kind of feel that given this character and how well it's doing, it would be pretty silly to attempt want to do the quest on normal. It would just be a walkover, I think. So I will give this a try. Hopefully the mind flayers don't eat me. All right. Okay, let's see what
You hear
happens.
plaintive wails from deep within the mines. Could they really be the voices of the dead?
I'm going to have to be pretty conservative with my use of spell points, I think, in here. Oh, man. Yes, it will take me a while to figure out how I best want to play these fights. There are also traps in here. Wakey wakey, tankettes. I wonder if I'm anywhere near on track with spell point use here. There's a long way to go. Well, on the plus side, it seems I can fight the Mind Flayers pretty safely. On the downside, I'm not sure I'm doing it cheaply. Well, I guess I do have some mnemonic pots in my inventory. Not very many, but some. Sheesh, these guys resist electric damage too. Bad news all round. Alright, this looks trappy. Which is bad news. Oh dear, this is probably gonna hurt. No, alright. Okay. I'm making progress. Oh. Sooner or later, one of those is going to be trappy. Thinking that the best time to use stone skin will be during these fights with the miners. Since I can't really heal while I'm surrounded by them. Clear shot to that guy. Looks pretty clear. Alright, got away with that one. This will be tougher though. Damn it, get over here. That guy was both a brute and a dumbass.
The ogre mage growls and commands his slaves to defend him. Lost Tanka's slaves spit on his corpse.
Well, that worked okay. Of course, they get harder. Maybe I should have put Eladar's on him. That lasts a bit longer, a bit higher damage. It would have kept going while he was phased out. Taking quite a few shots of this to take them down. It must be my most spell point efficient damage though, I would have thought. Well, still not dead.
Slaves chip away at the crystals while the ogres bark commands at them. The awful heat rising from the bottom of this shaft only adds to their misery.
That seems to be as good as I can do for now. It's going to be slow work. Yes, this is going to be slow work indeed. deliberately moving around a lot when I'm meleeing to try and prevent getting any glancing blows, of course. Oh, great, more miners up ahead. Yeah, this is a much more tricky spot, and I need to heal first. Oh, damn it. Now I've got to spend a minute running away. Great. Not much I can do but wait right now. If I go in with this death aura or any of those miners, they're all gonna die. One down. Where's the other or others? Great.
The ogre mage's eyes brim with intelligence and malice.
May have to drop out of undead form here. Not sure this is working right now.
Thank you.
Phew. Oh, damn it. Must only be one ogre left from this group, I hope. Yeah, I don't want to go wandering around in here with our death block on though. So I know there's at least one beholder. And the casters probably have some tricks up their sleeves as well. Well, we kite them in circles, I guess. Still haven't killed any. Close. That was a big group. All right. All right. Back out of undead form. Have my fortification on. Let's see how this goes. Quite a while since I've done anything out of undead form. Glad I'm still carrying around all these potions. Hopefully those get me to the shrine. This is ridiculous. This guy's got way too many hit points to sit around meleeing them. Sheesh. I can't knock anything in here. This is just as bad as the explorer area, I guess. Well, this is slow, but it's certainly interesting. Managed to land a hit. We're getting near the beholder. There must be a way forward yet. Which is bad news because the shrine is past the beholder, and I seem to be a long way away. Ah, damn it. Well, at least that combo works pretty well. Well, hopefully I've just got the one miner with the brute. Oh man, did I miss the brute with my melfs? Come on, tick down, tick down. Yes, yes, yes. Oh, come on. Okay. Yeah, and those buffs aren't going to make it to the Beholder fight, are they? Damn it. I am not looking good for mnemonic parts either here. Alright, there's a set of traps. They're behind me though, so I'll take that.
The Illithid's wicked speech invades your mind. Slaves, kill the surface dwellers.
Uh-oh. Yeah, that was rather dodgy. I don't know if I'm gonna make this. I look in pretty bad shape. And there go the buffs again. Well, I'm not getting hurt much by the traps. That's about the only positive thing I can say right now. Well, that kind of worked out. Expensive. But I'll take it. Wonder if I'm gonna be okay if I make the shrine. And if I make the shrine, it'll prolong the agony. Storm miners, maybe one more ogre up there. I've killed three, there can't be too many. This is one of those very rare occasions where I'm looking forward to the beholder.
The beholder hisses as you approach it.
Alright, how am I doing this fight? I've got no idea, to be honest. I could go back into undead form, or I could stay as I am. Don't know if this is a good idea or not. Alright, let's go meet it round the other way. Much as I dislike meeting a beholder head on, I think this is the best way to do it here. There's not any traps in here. Sheesh. They do not have the means to fight these guys. Thank you. Right, I clearly do not have a plan here. Well, that kind of worked out. Okay. Haha, awesome. Did I crit on that? I did. Wow. I figured it'd been okay anyway. All I really needed was to hit. Get some decent damage in early. Crit is a big bonus. Very welcome bonus. Wow, I made it to the shrine. I'm not sure if the risks were reasonable there. That got a bit too risky, really. And I'm certainly short of spell points versus where I would normally be doing this quest. Normally I would have done the side area as well before shrining. So I don't know if I'm good here or not. But I've made it further than it looked like I would a little while back. Right, I'm going to take a brief break there. Be right back. Okay. The other tricky thing here is whether to switch back to vampire form. I think I will have to go without that. Although it does trash my attack speed, being in zombie. Ooh, I don't know. Yeah, maybe I will go back to vampire. It's 50 spell points I can ill afford, but there it is. No, maybe I'll stick with zombie for now and I'll go to vampire later. Well, my armor is damaged as well. Maybe I'm not that terrible for spell points versus where I normally am. I have fought these guys, so it's only the room at the end here that I haven't fought, that I normally would have fought at this stage. Joy. Oh, great. Alright, well hopefully it's just the boss left down there. Alright, I'm not really sure how to do this, but we'll have to try something. Okay, here we go.
Ogre boss snarls in intent on cleaving you into pieces.
That didn't really work. At least I've drawn him out, I suppose. Ooh, well played.
Uzaki's slaves whoop and screech as the slave driver falls dead.
Well, took quite a few spell points. But I still haven't killed any miners, so I've got a good safety margin for beating the quest. And I've got a decent number of spell points still going here. This is still possible. It's tough, but it's still possible.
Laughs as you approach him.
Damn it, you got away. I think my knife's in the land. Crap.
Death is the only reward for betrayal.
Crap, backing me up into the trap. Well played again. Oh, I see, I haven't killed the, must still be ogres in there, Damn it, hit the wrong button. Yeah, not sure this plan's really working. Kind of worked. Crap, what am I doing here? Yeah, this could turn out to be an even worse idea.
slave driver waved a bunch of meat at his slaves and yelled, "No fight, no food."
Alright, well played. Crap, maybe the miner. Wow, no miners killed. Defeated. Wow, wow. Whew. Seemed I'd killed two or three in that fight. Alright, so I just gotta get through to that final mind flare. Tempting prospect. It would help if I knew where the final mind flayer was, of course. This looks promising. This looks somewhat familiar. Alright. I might even pull this off. Wow. I was not expecting to be able to pull this off. Okay. Alright. Last fight. Toughest fight. This is it. Do or die, probably. I guess if I get in serious trouble, I could try running past all this stuff down to the bottom of the lava pit. And hope I can find a safe spot to try and recall from. I think that's my best chance if I get in that much trouble. Okay, okay. Double check. Right, how about my healing hotbar? Okay. I think I'm good here. I think I'm good. Of course, it'll all go horribly wrong once I'm inside the room, but I think I'm good for now. Charisma damage. Glad I'm not in zombie form. Alright, sweet. I actually made it free. I did not.
Something catches your eye amidst the trinkets and drops.
I was seriously not expecting to get free that, judging by my performance at the halfway mark. Wow. First time I've soloed that one on hard. Wow, wow, wow. Actually made it free with some spell points to spare. Aggression, Vandal. Nice. Yeah, that was real tough. Wait, did I get the optional for the not killing the miners? No, maybe I didn't. Huh, that's a shame. I suppose I must have killed one. Alright. And there's my way out. Yeah, that was real hard. Not being able to use my aura most of the time. Not being able to use the skeleton. Not being able to use any area damage. And it was a hell of a time targeting the various ray spells in there to avoid the miners. Very tough. This actually might be quite handy. Wow, armored plus 8, that could work well for this guy, also. Choices, choices. Those look pretty unusual, those braces. I might grab those. They might be handy if I switch to a different, if I switch out of light armor, in order to save action points for using them in the spellcasting lines. As I'm using action points in the, Eldritch Night Tree at the moment to get light armor proficiency. That might allow me to switch out and still improve my AC. Alright, thanks for watching. That was quite a run. I realize it was pretty slow, but it was difficult as well, which made it interesting for me. Alright, I will see you next time.